Hi, I'm Valda Beebe. I'm the host and a visionary of That Celebrity Interview.
Thank you so very much for being here on the Valda Beebe Show. Thanks for waiting while I got my next guest. I've got Nick Cunningham, and I love people who do different things. He's up in Alaska. The Smithsonian Channel brings him to you in your living room on Ice Airport, Alaska. This is just fabulous. Welcome, Nick Cunningham, to the Valda Beebe Show for the first time.
Hey, thanks for having me. Glad to be able to come talk about Alaska and Ice Airport, Alaska, and the unique story that we have going on up here.
Well, I was just watching the screener they sent me, and I got cold. But you're used to this by now. Tell me about your experience.
I grew up in Minnesota, so I got a little bit of cold in my blood. So.
Oh, you're ready for this, then. You're totally ready, and you look like you're so at ease from what I saw. Tell me about Ice Airport, Alaska, because some of my social media audience weighed in and said, I hadn't watched this, I love this, I want to see this. So tell us about Ice Airport, Alaska.
Yeah, awesome. It's a great show that just kind of gives a overview of what takes place, what is necessary to keep our airports running up here in Alaska, specifically Ted Stevens International Airport. It's the fifth busiest cargo airport in the world. And not only that, we've got, 2 million visitors plus or minus coming to the state of Alaska through that airport. And then, of course, all the smaller operations like mine that are dealing with flight scene or cargo hauling or kind of more localized flying. And so it's pretty interesting to see just all the different facets of what goes into keeping our airport running that you might not have to in a place like Dallas, whether that's snow removal, customs and border patrol, immigration, airport police, some good stories there. And, of course, then there's, the wildlife, people making sure there's not moose on the runway. I know you don't have those down in Texas, but we've got those big moose.
No, we have possums in Texas.
Yeah.
We do.
And
let
armadillos.
Me ask you, were you? That's right. Those two. Let me ask you, were you a pilot in the military or something to give you this skill? Where did you get the skill from?
Well, real quick, I actually spent some time here in Alaska as a mountain guide. And while we were doing like helicopter skiing and mountaineering, we were always flying in airplanes and helicopters. And so as I kind of transitioned out of that career, quote unquote, I decided that I wanted to be the guy bringing people into the mountains or out into remote Alaska. And so I started flying about 11 years ago and then got my first job flying in 2013. So about 7 years ago, and have just been enjoying the Alaska aviation experience since.
Is Alaska different than, as you talked about, Texas? Is what you're doing different there than it is would be in Texas?
Yeah, and especially the, the lower 48, most places we can drive to, there's a road system of some kind, even if it's a dirt road, we've got the infrastructure down in Texas or the other states down there to get goods and services and people to lots, most places, 95% of the places that we live and travel to. And that's the big difference is up here. There's roads that access, just a couple percent of the state of Alaska. And of course, I hate to say it, but Alaska is, over twice the size of Texas and about two thirds the size of the lower 48. So when you start talking about a piece of land that's that big, if we're going to have, and we do have people living all across the state, we need to have a way to get them goods or, groceries or food or whatever. And so the aviation up here is not only more necessary for life, but it's also just very different because of the remoteness of where we fly. And then of course the terrain, we've got the country's North America's largest mountain is here, Mount Denali in the Alaska range. And then the mountains, of course, all the other ranges that go through there, the oceans and, just the expanses that are so grand. So that's what makes it really unique.
Okay. So when can we watch you on the Smithsonian Channel? Cause you make it so exciting.
Yeah, well, please check us out. It airs on Sundays at 8 p.m. Eastern Time on the Smithsonian Channel. It's a great show, great episodes, and always a different story and something to check out.
I think you're going to have some groupies, Nick, for what you do. We're going to be following you. And this is just fascinating to us because we don't hear a lot about Alaska, so this makes it very unique for us to want to follow. So thank you for stopping by the Valda Beebe Show.
Hey, you bet. Thanks. And check us out at Regal Air on Facebook or Regal Air on Instagram. And you can find out even more about Alaska Aviation.
All right. I'm headed over there now. We're going to find a lot more about you too, Nick. Thanks for being my guest. I really appreciate it.
All right. You have a good day, Valder. Appreciate it.
Happy holidays.
Hey, Merry Christmas to you. Thanks.
Head on over to myphonepouch.com.